Good evening, everybody. It is a beautiful night. It finally feels like fall. For the first time since maybe we've talked,
actually was a little too cold for me to practice. I'm getting old or something.
It's the night where you, like last night, you sleep with the window open, you wake up and you're frozen.
Exactly.
So, yeah, it's that time. So it came overnight, but we're glad it's here because it is finally football weather, and we have a lot to talk about regarding football and the Presbyterian College of Blue Hose. Welcome to the Tommy Spangler Coaches Show, sponsored by Founders Federal Credit Union and South Regional Lawrence. We are live from House of Pizza in Clinton. It is a great night to talk college football. We're going to talk about PC's game against Hampton last week, the Big South Conference game this Saturday against Charleston Southern, 6 p.m., the Buccaneers. It's going to be a rock fight. I think it's always a close game. We got a lot to talk about. We're going to be talking to Rod Haygood and Gavin James, and we've got a great hour lined up for you. Coach Tommy Spangler in the house. Coach, how are we doing tonight?
Doing good. We've had a good couple days, Ryan. You know, I know we're going to talk about Hampton, but we kind of got to get back on track. Excited about the game coming up with Charleston Southern. It always seems to be a grinder, you know. It's always pretty close. I'm not sure they're too thrilled about us, and we're not too thrilled about them. It's in a good way as far as the competitiveness of the game. So it's always been a pretty good rival. So excited about the week. We've had a good week. We just finished up a Thursday practice. The guys seem to be into it. The guys, are trying to bounce back from, what was a tough loss Saturday.
Sure. The game against Hampton, the Zeta Tau Alpha pink out game, which was great to see, a great event that they put on. Back and forth, really close game. There were some positives. Particularly, I want to talk about that last drive. I know it didn't end in the way you wanted to with the extra point, but John Walker, really gutting it out, makes a play with his legs, some arms, and really led that drive where he even had to score two touchdowns to make it count.
Yeah, all those things are good. It's like I talked to the team a little bit, Ryan, at the end of the game. I wish it wouldn't have had to come to that, if that makes sense.
Sure.
But it did, and you got to give our offense some credit for grinding it out, getting a big fourth down, having a touchdown, getting it denied based on instant replay, coming back, scoring again with a true freshman, Jordan Morgan, that ran it in. A lot of good things, but obviously, I guess the silver lining behind it was, I think back in December, back in January, back in February, had somebody said, hey, coach, you're going to play Hampton right to the wire and get beat by 1 point, I would have said, you're crazy. They're probably going to beat us four or five touchdowns, But the simple fact is we haven't made excuses. I'm not going to make excuses about what's basically happened to the program and this and that. We had every bit an opportunity to win that game. You were you saw it. You saw it. We made some crucial mistakes at some crucial times against a good football team, against a team that had a lot of good athletes. And, just felt like not to give, let's give Hampton credit. I mean, sure, we need to do that. But at the same time, I felt like we really, and our kids, I think after watching the tape, knew we left one out there that we could have got.
And that's you touched on something that we talked about last week, where the idea of the fight and the, you're going to be in these tough games where they go back and forth. And
right.
I mean, that's just a fact. So the fortitude, I guess, and the, the will to keep, you're never out of it. And you're
right.
Always,
right.
Fighting
that's right.
back. That's something we saw on Saturday.
Well, it was a good first half and a not so good third quarter.
Right.
We're up 17-7 at half, come out third quarter, they drive it, they score. Okay, they're a good team, make it 17-14. But then we kind of went on a little bit of a – we settled in defensively, we roughed the punter. We got fortunate there to kind of get them stopped. They punted again, we dropped the punt. And defense does a pretty good job to hold to a field goal. So all of a sudden in the
right.
third quarter, I'm not sure the offense is – taking a snap, and it's 17-7, and there's where I thought our guys did for the most part a good job of not getting too down, continuing to battle, understanding. But ultimately, it's like I told the team after the game, Ryan, we kind of won the scoreboard 17-7, but the most important half, which is the second, we lost 17-6,
right.
And there was the one point difference.
A few individual performances. One young man we're going to talk to tonight, Rod Haygood, getting his first interception. He made some big plays last year. And then Deshaun Davis, setting the Division I record for receptions.
Yeah, Deshaun's done an awesome job, and we're glad he's with us. And, Rod Haygood, which was big, we actually punt the ball away to Hampton. They had a pretty nice return with good field position, and he actually intercepted the ball on first down.
Yeah.
So it was a great play by him. And I told him yesterday, he's starting to make plays. Rod's coming off of an ACL a year ago against Charleston Southern. So it's just right at a year now. And he's still kind of working his way back into things physically and mentally too. It's hard to come off of that ACL. But you got to give him credit. He's done a great job. He hadn't missed many reps all season. Mm-hmm. And he's played about every play of every game for us and to this point. And he's only a sophomore. We're looking forward to having him for two more years, but just can't say enough about the kind of play he's making as of late. He continues to improve.
Well, that's something we mentioned last week with that interception in the end zone 2 weeks ago. But those kinds of plays where you intercept a ball on first down, where they're starting to get some momentum, they're starting to put some plays together, and you immediately get the ball back.
No doubt,
those can turn a game.
No doubt, and that's why you look usually at the end of the game. A lot of stats. A lot of people like to look at stats. The stats I look at are who's turned it over the most, mm-hmm. and what teams grabbed it the most, that type thing. And it's not a lot of times about total yards. It's about penalties. It's about the discipline factor. It's the turnovers. It's mm-hmm. the takeaways, those kind of things, explosive plays, missed tackles, all those kind of things that are important to playing good defense and good offense. But, it's kind of a bittersweet position we're in. We're disappointed that we dropped that game, knowing we very well should have and could have. But I'm proud of the way the guys competed, and, Hampton's good enough that they could have come in here and got after us pretty good had we let them. So we'll see. We're gonna rebound. Go play a really tough team this week, and a team that's traditionally very good, not quite having the kind of season I think they want, but they've played a pretty tough schedule too.
Mm-hmm. And they might have taken it out on Virginia Lynchburg last week and are ready to start the Big South. We're going to talk about that in the next segment, because we're talking to Tommy Spangler on the Tommy Spangler Coaches Show, sponsored by Founders Federal Credit Union and South Regional Lawrence from House of Pizza in Clinton. So you mentioned, you looked at the film and you said the guys kind of know that there was one on the table.
Yeah.
And you just talked about how, the fight and turning the page. But so that was something I was thinking about Saturday night is kind of, okay, that was a close game. That was a tough loss. So what's the message this week ahead of a very good Charleston Southern team?
Yeah, I think the message is, and it's pretty awesome when you got a group of kids that you can go into a meeting after the game. You could study the tape. You can look at the tape. Obviously, a picture's worth 1,000 words. And those kids can see the things we can do better. And that had we done this, we very well could have won that game. So that's a positive, And now, are you willing to go to the practice field and get those things corrected and at the same time apply those things to a possibly different game plan, a different type of offense, a different type of defense, a different type of special teams, and continue to develop as a football team throughout the year, And that's what – good teams do. Good teams get better throughout the year. And it's like I tell our guys all the time, what you do in game week preparation of week two may or may not help you game two.
Right.
But it might help you game three or game four,
Yeah.
So you got to continue to go to the practice field every day and continue to try to develop as an individual, thus as a unit, DBs, linebackers, running backs, so forth, thus as a offense and defense, and then, before you know it, you develop as a team. So, there's a lot of good things happening in the program. We've dropped two straight, one we should have had, one we got kind of beat pretty good. But there's some positives. There's some positives. You know, you look at what Lindsey Wilson did. I think they scored 73 points the week after we shut them out, you know, and then they had a huge win against Georgetown a couple weeks later. So there's some things we can look and draw from the positive side, which ought to give us some confidence and keep us going. But at the same time, there's enough for us to correct that we need to continue to focus on to get better. So there's a balance to it.
So from a coaching perspective, I'm curious. We're halfway through the season. You played five games. Do you take – you know, the schedule is so routine, you know, a game week routine.
Sure.
You play on Saturday. Is there time, or is that something you even want to do, to pull back and kind of take a longer view, large view, or is it just, you know, on to the next week?
It's a little of both. But, you know, what's strange is you said you get in this routine. We really haven't been in a routine.
That's
because
a good
point. It's been such an unusual year.
That's a good
point, you know,
yeah.
We've played on Thursday. We've had a game canceled. We've had rain delays. We've had this. We've had rain that's run us off the field, lightning. We've had to go in from practice and come back out from practice. So, but I agree with you. There is a fine line between, okay, hit the pause button for a second. Let's evaluate where we are, okay? Let's evaluate where we are and where we want to go. And go back to the what I call the ABCs of football. You know, let's don't get caught up too much about – Charleston Southern, let's get caught up about us. What's it going to take for us to get better? What do you as an individual need to be to get better at and so forth? So you're right. There's a lot of self-evaluating, a lot of self-scouting, meaning, hey, what have we done on defense to tip some people that we need to change? What have we done on offense that we may be tipping a little bit, that people are studying and so forth. So, yeah, you're right, Ryan. There's a time. I think all good teams do that where they kind of hit the pause button for a second and say, look, man, we've got to kind of take a deep breath here. Let's reboot. Let's reboot. Let's turn the computer off a little bit and start it back up, and let's see where that takes us, because it really is about fundamentals. And when it came down to the difference in Saturday's game, you can talk with – it was this fundamental, that fundamental, this fundamental, and that's what football's about.
And you know, certainly to take that larger view where, you know, this is an offense that you've seen can put points on the board. John Walker's been able to lead the offense. You've got, you know, great running backs. You've got Deshaun Davis and Keith Pearson, and which is, you know, That's an improvement, and you've got, you know, one of the best pass defenses in FCS football, and you've seen them come up with some big plays at some key times. So I think you're able to – when you do that, you're able to point to some things.
You are, and there's – like you said, there's always some good things and always some not good things. And, you know, I'm a little bit along the lines of making sure we stay humble, making sure we stay hungry, making sure – that we've got a little bit more confidence in what we can do than maybe the circumstances dictate. Because like I said, you know, you look back in December and January, Ryan, I was concerned we'd have a football team, much less a competitive football team. So, you know, you gotta look at each thing and be grateful for it and humble for it and understand that, thank goodness, we were in the game Saturday. Now what we got to try to find a way to do is win that, because that very well could be the case Saturday against Charleston Southern.
Three out of the last four games against Charleston Southern have been one possession games.
Right.
So that's it might come down to
yeah,
that.
Yeah, I think it's been 10-7, 7-3, 7-0, those kind of deals.
It's not 50-43.
Right, yeah, right.
So we're going to talk about Charleston Southern when we come back. We're going to take our first break of the night. It's so good to talk to Coach Spangler and talk Presbyterian College football. It's the highlight of my week. We are going to take a break. When we come back, talk about the Buccaneers, a big 6 o'clock game down in North Charleston. That's when we return to the Tommy Spangler Coaches Show, sponsored by Founders Federal Credit Union and South Regional Lawrence, live from House of Pizza in Clinton. Welcome back to the Tommy Spangler Coaches Show, sponsored by Founders Federal Credit Union and Self Regional Lawrence live from House of Pizza in Clinton. I can smell pizza a table over, and it smells
incredible. This place is awesome.
It is.
I mean, look at the TVs around here. I mean, how about that?
You got your TVs. You got
beverages. I'm distracted. I don't even see you, Ryan. I'm distracted. I hope something important doesn't come on the TV because you'll lose me.
No. Yeah, they'll put football on later. And
yeah,
be,
okay.
Yeah, and then it'll be over for me. Okay, anyway, Charleston Southern, Coach, big game this weekend, 6 o'clock, Carolina Concrete, pregame show. You can listen right here.
What a great sponsor, Carolina Concrete, for a football team. That's what it ought to be. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely, yeah, for sure. They're right up the road and, kind of embodies the defense, I think.
Exactly, just toughness, you know?
Yeah, absolutely. And you're going to have a tough game this weekend.
Oh, yeah.
2-3 Charleston Southern. I don't think that tells the story. This is their Big South Conference opener, and it's homecoming because God forbid you get an easy one. You know?
Well, I think people like to pick us as homecoming. I told the team there, people have homecoming for us sometimes in September when you shouldn't have homecoming. But that's okay. Mm-hmm. That's okay. We're excited about them. They played Elon, who's a heck of a team this year, beat the stew out of Furman and actually beat James Madison. And we're really nip and tuck there with Elon for a little bit. Played Florida, which, obviously the outcome there. But and then played a pretty good Savannah State team. So, I don't think any of their losses are ones that they're too disappointed in.
And you have a good pass defense. They have a great pass defense. I didn't mean to say good and great because it's 1-2 in FCS in terms of pass defense. So, you look at them and their myth that one of their All-Americans didn't get or watch list didn't get, preseason Big Conference or Big South Conference. They have all these guys who made the Big South Conference team. And so you're going to get, a good shot.
No doubt. And like I said, there's no love lost between our two programs, even though I think there's a lot of respect for both programs. If you go back, really a couple years ago, Ryan, they whipped us decently down there at their place, even though we played good. It was 0-0 after the first quarter. Gave up a couple big plays in the second quarter. But if you look at some of the scores over the last 4 years, I think – in 14, we beat them down there 7-3.
Yep.
We came up here, I think we lost 10-7. Last year, we lost 7-0. So they've been some knockdown dragouts against, two pretty good football teams. And, we've got a lot of respect for them. Don't like them very much, but we've got a lot of respect for them and what they do. And they'll have a good atmosphere down there. But I think our guys are excited about going to Charleston Southern. This is a good league team. This is a good league rival. We've played. I remember even when I was the head coach years ago when we were Division II, we always seemed to play Charleston Southern. And at the time, they were an independent Division I team, and we always got excited because our name could get on the ticker that night, and Presbyterian would actually show up on the bottom of the screen on ESPN and so forth. So we'd get excited about that because we were fortunate to win quite a few of those. So it's a good rival, and they do a good job and have a lot of my respect.
Why do you think that is, where sometimes just certain teams, when they get together, it's always, like I mentioned earlier, it's a rock fight, or it's a close game. Why? You see another team like Syracuse, for instance, a couple weeks ago against Clemson. It's just, for whatever reason,
Well, it's number one, I think we're in state, and we do battle against them recruiting on some kids. And, we've played them for a very long time. I think their defense has a pretty good understanding of what we're trying to accomplish on offense. I think our defense has proved that, we've got a pretty good feel for their option attack and so forth. So, I don't know. It's interesting. I just think both teams, even though, like I said, maybe don't have a lot of love for each other, I think deep down both teams have respect. And when you have respect for your opponent, you seem to amp it up a little bit. Maybe that's why both teams have really played well against each other the last few years.
And you mentioned early in the show about what you can look at other teams weaknesses, things to take advantage of, where you're not looking at the stats in terms of just overall yardage, or yeah. you're looking for the stats that really jump out to you. Turnovers is one of them. This is a team that, you know, you might be able to take advantage of some turnovers and try and force them.
Well, we hope so. I think that's on a game-to-game basis, though, because, you know, you've seen some teams that may turn it over three or four times in a game, and then the next week they don't turn it over at all and so forth. But we're hoping. This is really going to be, and, you know, Ryan, not to be – sound like a head coach too much here, but it really is going to be this one weekend for about three and a half hours against a very good team, and we're going to have to go execute and make our own break, so to speak. And you know, it's still going to come down to making some plays on offense when it's time, trying to sustain some drives to where we're not just turning it into a punt fest. I think Coach Ork understands that we're going to have to run the ball a little better, and we're going to have to play better run defense. You know, we have not played very good run defense. Now, it skews the stats a little bit when you play Kennesaw State, but
right.
we have not played as good against the run as I'd like to. Mm-hmm. I don't think we've run the ball as good consistently as we'd like to. I think that's what we would need to do to beat Charleston Southern. I think they're probably thinking the same thing. So usually, you know, I like the pass defense stat. I'm not a, you know, I remember the years, yeah. all the years at Georgia Southern, you know, we were always number one in rush defense and about last in pass defense, because we'd be beating the slop out of teams and teams would be throwing it all over the yard on us. So, I'm glad we're up there in pass defense. I'm not overly excited. I'd much rather be a good run defense. Mm. than a good pass defense. I think what you'd see is, if you looked at the NCAA stats, FBS or FCS, the top rush defenses are usually, you know, you look at their overall record and the kind of success they're having as a team, it correlates. Mm-hmm.
You mentioned, you know, the offense and what you're trying to do and what you've, you know, what you've worked on. You know, you have a new offensive coordinator. I know you know that, obviously. But is watching this team from – fall and the new things that you and Coach Ork have been trying to implement to halfway in the season, you know, where do you see that kind of a line?
Well, it is, you know, sometimes you can look at, okay, it is about, I mean, to me, the game's simple. I mean, you got to outscore your opponent. So points are big. Now, we haven't done a great job overall of averaging points. Mm-hmm. We got to do better with that. We've got to be able to, I don't know, in this modern day of college football, you know the deal. I mean, you got to be able to score, because it's getting tougher and tougher to play defense, and that's why you see these crazy games at 48-45. Now, I get that. We're not going to be able to win probably 48-45. We're going to have to play good enough defense. But then again, if we do get in one of those games where we need 27, we need 31 to win, that's what we're going to have to do. But on the other hand, I've seen some improvement. Okay, I've seen a little bit better consistency on how we go about things on offense. I like our quarterback, John Walker. I like our backup quarterback. I like our running backs. I like our offensive line. I like our receivers. I mean, it's just really continuing to gel, continuing to play together, continuing to build some confidence and just see where this thing goes. But ultimately, you know, we got to knock it in. Like, for instance, and I'm not trying to bring up negative things, but what's real is real. We had the ball inside the five for four times on the first drive of Saturday, and we couldn't punch it in. You know, you got to be able to punch that in and go up 7-0 rather than 3-0. And
right.
Those are things we got to improve on. And Coach Ork knows that, and that's why he's a good coach. And he understands you've got to be able to run the football and be hard-nosed enough to keep people honest enough to where they're not just playing pass defense and taking away some things we do well.
This weekend, Charleston Southern, 6 o'clock. We're going to talk to two young men here after the break, Gavin James and Rod Haygood. Set these guys up a little bit. We never talk to the – we never – offensive linemen do not get enough.
Offensive linemen epitomize what the game's about, you know, because I guess unless they just pick up a fumble, you know, they never get to touch the ball. you know, the game is so fast and so quick that people don't really see the execution of the offensive lineman during a game. Maybe like they see a quarterback or a running back or a receiver or a DB and that kind of thing that's obvious. You know, hey, he picked one off. He made a great catch. He made a great run. They don't really see the point of attack execution by OL. Hey, what a great block. What a great protection. What those kind of things. So, you know, offensive linemen have got a soft spot in my heart. I appreciate what they do. They're team-oriented, obviously, and Gavin James, a true freshman out of West Oak High School, who, unfortunately, he came up to me after the totally forgot about it, Ryan. He came up to me after the Bluefield game and said, "Coach, that's the first game I've won in 2 years." I said, "Well, I'm happy for you. I'm not very happy on how your high school career went, but I'm happy that you got a W, big man." And then when we beat Lindsey Wilson, I said, "Hey, two in a row is called a win streak." You know, so
yeah.
Just a great person, a strong Christian kid that's just an awesome, gonna be a heck of a player. And, you know, I don't care what anybody says. You play as a true freshman, you got something about you.
Sure, sure. And then you got Rod Higgett over here, who we mentioned earlier. But
you know, we used to kind of be loaded with Florida guys. I want to say Rod might be one of the few, if not the only, Florida guy that we about got left on the roster.
Yeah.
And we signed Rod late, one of those deals, and I've never seen it. I've always seen it happen, meaning that those late signee guys turn out to be some of your best players.
Yeah.
You know, you make a decision late. Well, should we take this guy? Should we not? We decided to take Rod, and he's been a heck of a player. What a great person, good student, great ambassador to our program. And I told him yesterday, he's starting to make plays on the ball. He's had more interceptions in practice. He had a big interception on Saturday. And we'll see. We hope he can get it done on this Saturday against Charleston Southern.
Can't wait to see that. We are going to take a break when we come back. We're going to talk to Gavin James and Rod Haygood. That's coming up on the Tommy Spangler Coaches Show, sponsored by Founders Federal Credit Union and South Regional Lawrence, right here from House of Pizza in Clinton. Welcome back. It is Thursday night. That means we are talking Presbyterian College football live from House of Pizza in Clinton on the Tommy Spangler Coaches Show, sponsored by Founders Federal Credit Union and South Regional Lawrence. The Blue Hose will be in North Charleston this weekend, taking on Charleston Southern in their conference opener. 6 p.m., you can listen right here, 96.5 FM in Clinton, 98.3 FM in Spartanburg. Only one game in town this week for the Blue Hose. That's men's soccer hosting Longwood at 2 o'clock. You can go watch the Blue Hose beat the Lancers. Then you go home, turn on ESPN Plus, and watch Rod Haygood and the Blue Hose beat the Buccaneers. Rod Haygood, thank you for joining us from Glen St. Mary, Florida, Baker County High School. How are you doing tonight?
I'm doing great.
Thank you for taking time out of your Thursday night, the one free night that you might have this week. But appreciate it. How has this week been for you?
It's been a pretty good week, coming off a kind of tough home loss, you know. Got to get back refocused to play a good team, so really just going back to the drawing board, you know, getting the schematics, you know, all that figured out.
Congratulations on your first interception last week. How was that?
It was fun, you know. They had been kind of running this kind of backside zone stretch looking play, and I guess they thought that I was going to bite up for it. And they tried to throw it a little slant. I just jumped it, made a play. And it's kind of funny, before we went on the field, our starting Nick, Michael Fisher, he was like, "Hey, we got to make a play. We got to get the ball back." And then we did. You know, the crowd was feeling it. The energy was there. It was just real fun.
That's awesome. That's great. How has this year been for you? You know, sophomore, there's a lot of off-season turmoil. But how has this season been so far halfway through?
Well, last year I tore my ACL around the same time, actually playing Charleston Southern.
Okay.
The same time of year. So, you know, I had to deal with that in the off-season, you know, getting back, recovering, you know, rehabbing my leg and all that. And then all this went down with the team and stuff, and I went from being like, you know, a special teams guy, you know, limited role guy, to, hey, you're going to have to start the season for us. You know, my whole offseason was like, hey, I got to get ready. I got to push myself. I got to get back right. And then, you know, we get into fall camp, and Coach Spang is in my ear like, hey, your knee's going to be ready. We're going to get you there. You know, he takes it easy on me. He didn't overwork me. You know, he let me kind of get back into the field of things and then get into the season, start playing, you know, first couple college games, you know, I'm nervous before games because, you know, I put a lot of pressure on myself to play well. You know, I don't want to let down the older guys that, you know, this is their last ride, you know. But I feel like this year I've done pretty well as far as, like, you know, holding my own as I get my knee back right. You know, it's not all the way there, but it's every game I feel like I get more comfortable, you know, get more feeling myself again.
Well, that was something he mentioned earlier in the show where, you know, you coming back from that injury, not only just physically, but mentally too, you know, because a lot of guys talk about coming back on knees and, you know, that first cut or that, you know, that first hit. But he also said, you couldn't hear just now, but, you know, you're starting to make plays, you know, and you can see that. So is that something you consciously think about? I mean, it sounds like you're kind of a cerebral guy, but, you know, every week, you know, improving in this area or this knee's feeling better, I'm okay with it. I mean, but that had to be tough to start, right?
Yeah, when you're coming back off of it, you're like, dang, you know, is this going to hurt? Is this going to hurt? And then you got to build that trust back up, which I think that's kind of was one of the biggest things in my rehab is I wasn't really scared to, like, push myself.
Okay.
Like, when some guys come back off of injuries, you see that they kind of hold back on it or they're timid. And I was just – I kind of came into it with the mindset of, like, you can't – like, you there's a lot of work to be done, so you got to just go ahead and just go at it. So in the off season, you know, I would work out and I would go at it. And, you know, I wouldn't hold back on my knee if – and my mindset was, you know, if it happens, it happens, you know, but I gotta get where I need to be. And that's kind of where I've been this season. But it's always, like, mental hang-ups, you know, stuff you got to work over. Mm-hmm. And I think I do a good job of, like, taking it week in and week out, taking, like, weak points of what I need to do and just kind of fixing.
You mentioned Michael Fisher because we had Robert Baker on the show last year, and really him and Fisher are the older guys, you know, in that where you are and that position group. So you know, are a sophomore, and you talked about coming from being a special teams guy last year to starting, you know, in the backfield. For you, you know, is that something where, you know, you don't have a group of older guys behind you, you know, or with you in the defensive backfield? How does that play for you?
Well, last year, you know, we had a kind of veteran corner, Rock.
Yeah.
And I kind of spent a lot of time with him, me and Dirk, the other corner. And he kind of showed us the ropes and stuff like that. So coming into, like, the spring and repping a lot and stuff like that, we kind of already had, like, that older guy kind of show us what it was and what it took, you know. And then, you know, with Rob and Mike and Michael and all them, it was like, you know, they do a good job of making sure, like, we know what we got to do, you know, kind of showing us, like, that leadership role as far as the secondary goes. Like, hey, you know, be on your, you know, on top of stuff. You know, don't just relax and, you know, they make sure we're focused on the mental aspect of things. So it's not really that bad, you know. We got some younger DBs that, you know, now I'm in the kind of older guy role, too, where I got to show them the ropes as well. Like, you know, I got to be kind of like that big brother on the field. Like, hey, we don't do this here, you know. We play a certain way here, right. You know, that's not going to fly, you know, that type of thing.
And it came on you a little bit quicker than you may have thought coming in. Coming into PC, Coach mentioned you were, you know, they got you a little bit later out of Baker County. So talk to me about that decision to come to PC and kind of how that transpired.
Well, my senior year, I wasn't really that heavily recruited. You know, I had some smaller offers, stuff like that. And then Coach Ort, he handles most of the recruiting. He came and talked to me. And he was like, you know, we're going to be straight up with you. We kind of got some guys on the board. We've kind of already reached out and kind of offered to, so we don't know where you stand, you know. They had got me real late in the season. And he was like, but you're on the top of our board as far as, like, other guys. So if they don't, you know, commit on those offers, you're the first person we're coming to. And, you know, I was like, all right, you know, that's cool. We kept it straight up, didn't leave me on.
Yeah.
Reached out to me later on. He was like, they accepted the offers and stuff like that, so we ain't got one for you. So I'm like, cool. So then I go into, you know, after football season, finish up high school, and I'm just going into my summer thinking, you know, am I going to go to college for football? Am I just going to be, you know, a regular student? And then I get a call, and they were like, hey, got an offer for you. What you want to do? And I was like, you know, it was kind of last minute. You know, I talked it over with my people, and I was like, this is something I wanted to do. So I came up here.
And look at you now. Two years later, and you're starting in the defensive backfield for the Blue Hose. It's funny how life works out, how things
happen.
It's
crazy.
So tell me about, you know, what you like to do. Did you play basketball in high school?
Yeah,
did you do that for a bit? Okay, do you still play now?
You know, of course not in season.
Right.
They do, like, you know, some little stuff around here, like, you know, intramural teams and stuff. I was hurt last winter and stuff like that, so I couldn't participate in none of that. But I kind of look forward to, you know, getting into that this year, you know. Yeah, I like to play basketball. I like to fish.
Okay.
Know, stuff like that. I don't fish up here just because I don't really know anywhere to go.
Yeah.
You know? But when I'm home, I like to do that. I mainly just – I'm in my room, you know, chilling, watching TV, relaxing, enjoying the free time I got while
right.
I got it.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, it's good to appreciate that when you have
yeah.
it. Yeah. What are you studying?
I want to be a biology major.
Okay.
Yeah. So that's – and then after I do that, I kind of want to go into grad school – to get a degree as a sports trainer.
Okay.
Yeah, that's something I'm really interested in because I kind of have this, I wouldn't really call it bad luck, but when I do get injuries in sports, it's usually really bad because my freshman year of high school, I broke my ankle.
Okay.
And both bones. And then, you know, I was going through the rehab with all that, and I was, like, so interested in these people's job, you know, like, they just deal with people's injuries, and they're around sports teams all the time. And I'm like, that's something I could really get into because, you know,
yeah.
I'm a people person. You know, I like to – and I like sports.
Right,
and
yeah.
And, you know, one day I want to be a coach and stuff. So I was like, you know, why not?
Right, yeah. It's like the perfect marriage of, you know, you get to stay in sports, you mm-hmm. get to help people.
Make
and,
money, too. Yeah, good
yeah,
money,
there's
you
also,
know.
There's also that, yeah. You can't deny that, can't minimize that. Talking to Rod Haygood out of Baker County High School, Glen St. Mary, Florida. You got a good Charleston Southern team this weekend. They're going to be ready for you. It's homecoming for them. It's a night game. They got a very good receiver in Cameron Brown and a good, you know, offensive core. When you look at them on film and what you've seen in your meetings, you know, what is something that sticks out for you? Something, you know, that you're ready for?
Mainly when I watch film on them guys, and I can't speak for everybody on the defense and stuff like that. What really sticks out for me is they play a pretty fast game, you know. They do a lot as far as, like, movement, not necessarily, like, shifts and stuff like that, but as far as, like, trying to throw you off, they'll have the quarterback do this little rotation thing, and they'll fake pulls and stuff like that to try and get you to move how they want you to. You know, they like to try and get in situations that are favorable for them as far as what I see. But, you know, they got some decent receivers, which is probably what I'll be dealing with most of the night. I won't – because the offense they run, they like to split out receivers, and I won't be in the box and the run support as much as I would like to because I'm kind of like a run support corner. I like to be in there. You know, I like the more physical part of the game. But I'll be covering receivers. They got some pretty decent ones. They got some good skill players. I can't really speak for their O-line because I don't really know what to look for and stuff like that. But they're just a overall solid team, you know, challenge for us this weekend. So I'm ready to.
Coming into the summer, so where you are now, week 5, maybe what's been like the biggest thing for you, the biggest takeaway, biggest improvement, or something you're like, man, I'm a different person in this way than I was from the summer?
Probably just like my overall, just my body in general, just coming off the summer, you know, after I had my surgery, I put on a lot of weight because I couldn't work out and stuff like that. And then, you know, I tried to cut weight, but when I come off my surgery, I couldn't run. I couldn't, like, do anything as far as cardio and stuff, so it's hard to cut weight when you can't run and do things like that. So during the summer, I would try to, you know, lose weight, this, that, and other, but I kind of struggled with it. So then I came into fall camp kind of overweight, and coach was like, you know, Rod, you're not moving as good as you did last year. Maybe if you, you know, worked on trying to cut some weight, you know, you'll move a little better. So I took that to heart, and I went into practice with the mindset, like, working, you know, and then after practice, I would, like, watch my weight, watch what I ate, you know, try to slim down, you know. And after a while, I did start to feel better, start to move better, you know, felt like I was putting a lot less stress on my knee and stuff like that. So I think that's really the biggest overall change this year for me is just losing some weight, moving a lot better. And I think that really helped me once we started actually playing games and stuff. I felt, you know, better as far as my wind and stuff. And, you know, as far as me and Dirk go, we don't come off the field a lot. There's not really a whole lot of rotations with the DB, so that's really important, me being able to play those, you know, 80-something snaps a game.
Sure, as that night goes on, as that day goes on.
You know.
Yeah, absolutely. Rod Haygood, we get you out of here on this. Is there anything I didn't ask you or something that you want people to know about you before we take a break?
Not really, though. You know, I got some shout-outs, though. I want to shout-out all my, you know, teammates, Deshaun Davis, Keith Pearson, you know, the receivers on the other side of the ball that get us better every day, my quarterback, Johnny. All my DBs, Dirk, Trent, Rob, Fish, all the freshman DBs that came in. They're doing a great job as far as, you know, taking on the challenges that, you know, come with your freshman year of college football, stuff like that. Just pretty much the whole team, you know. We I feel like we've been doing a good job this season of just showing, like, no matter what's going on, you know, we gonna fight.
Rod Haygood, appreciate you coming out tonight.
Appreciate you for having me.
That was Rod Haygood. We're going to take a break. When we come back, we're going to talk to offensive lineman Gavin James. That's in just a minute right here on the Tommy Spangler Coaches Show, sponsored by Founders Federal Credit Union and South Regional Lawrence, live from House of Pizza in Clinton. Welcome back to the Tommy Spangler Coaches Show, sponsored by Founders Federal Credit Union and South Regional Lawrence, live from House of Pizza in Clinton. Right now, joining us tonight, freshman offensive lineman Gavin James out of Westminster, South Carolina at West Oak High School. Gavin, how are you doing tonight?
I'm good, man. How are you?
Good, good. Thanks for joining us. I'm sorry I got to get out of the way first. Gavin James, not the songwriter, the famous.
I've all heard the a time, lot about it.
I know. I have a friend whose name Alexa, which 5 years ago was fine, but now everybody's like, hey,
yeah.
Alexa.
Yeah.
But also Gavin James, his real name is Gavin Wigglesworth. And so it's
man,
kind of, I know.
Come on.
You come by it, honestly. I appreciate you joining us tonight. Appreciate you coming to House Pizza, grabbing some pizza.
Oh, yeah, man.
And,
thanks for having me.
And talking football. How are you? How has your week been?
It's been good, man. It's you know, I've had the opportunity to sit down and break down some film and whatnot and look at last week and, you know, try to fix some things. So it's definitely, it's been a week to learn, you know, and get ready for a pretty solid defensive line, you know. So
sure.
Some good cats up there. So I'm excited for the opportunity.
Yeah, and this year, you know, you're a freshman. You're halfway through the season. Is it kind of been a whirlwind? Is it taking a long time? Does it feel?
You know, it's been a learning curve for sure. You know, because I'm still kind of green. You know,
sure.
with some stuff. It's been fun though. It's
yeah.
been a lot of fun. You know, this is the most fun I've ever had playing football in my life for
okay.
sure.
Yeah.
Had a tough, you know, time in high school with football. I don't know if Coach Spangler, anybody
he did
mentioned
mention it.
It. Yeah.
He did,
so
yes.
it's. First time in 3 years, you know, that that Bluefield game. So that was awesome, man. You know, I couldn't leave football with, you know, that bitter taste. So
right.
it's just fun to be a part of a program, you know, and put in some work and, you know, it show off, you know, at the end of the night. That's been great, man. I'm excited, you know, for the opportunities that are coming, you know, the next five games.
Sure. And you know, tell me about your position group, the linemen, because I feel like the offensive line in particular has such a strong bond. I mean, you have to.
Oh,
really.
Oh yeah, of course. You know, we're all the fat guys. We're the big guys
yeah.
up front. You know, and there's this page I follow on social media. It's I think it's called Lineman Issues. They
uh-huh.
say linemen lead the way, and you know, Pancake Platoon and stuff
yeah,
like that.
Yeah, sure.
So yeah, we definitely have a good bond, man.
yeah.
It's great because you know we can always joke around about stuff. You know, we can always make fun of each other about our weight and whatnot.
Right.
So we're really close, man. We're tight. We're really tight. You know, you have to be because
sure.
you know you're. You're up front, and you're grinding through things. You're pushing through people together, and there's a lot of teamwork up front, you know, with combo blocks and whatnot, communicating. So that's huge. That's huge. And you know, the more and more you're around them, the more they're like your brothers.
Yeah.
You know, it's awesome. It's a fun time up front.
And you got Coach Ork, who you know, coordinated the offense, who played here as
exactly.
an offensive lineman. So
yeah.
he knows the deal, and he knows
exactly.
kind of what you're going
yeah,
through.
Yeah, he's the real deal. I appreciate Coach Ork and everything he's you know done for me. He. You know, pretty much took me under his wing coming in, and he's encouraged me a lot. And he's just, you know, over and over reminding me, hey, man, you're going to be a good player. You just, you know, keep working, keep doing your thing. Yeah, he for sure knows his stuff.
Yeah.
I love Coach Ort, man.
Rod mentioned something earlier about, like, the younger guys on the team and taking care of them, and more to the point of figuring out college. Has that been an adjustment for you?
You know, in some ways, yeah. It hasn't been too terrible, I think. I think, you know, college, when you're coming in, everybody creates this whole, you know, idea of what it is. It's this big, scary thing. It's way harder than high school. But once – I think football really helps, you know.
Yeah.
Because once you're in the grind of football, you know, it's kind of like school becomes second nature. So
yeah.
it's really fun, actually. I really enjoy it because you're staying so busy all the time. You don't have time to really worry or think about anything.
Sure.
You know, you just have fun with it and you just keep going.
Sure, sure. You're a wrestler.
Yes.
Tell me about that. I mean, I know you're state champion.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
So wrestled for West Oak High School. Definitely one of the better programs in all of the state. You know, I was very fortunate to be, you know, around a group of guys like that in the program because, see, my freshman year, we won team. Sophomore year, I won my individual, my first individual. Junior year, we won my second team, my second individual. And then this past year, my senior year, we won our third team and my third individual.
Wow, yeah.
So, yeah, it was, man, it's awesome.
Right.
Fun experience for sure. And wrestling, it's taught me so much about, you know, life and football especially, too, because it's just, you know, going through camp, it's a grind, you know. That those first few weeks in, it was It's tough. There's no kidding. But football taught, or I'm sorry, wrestling taught me so much about, you know, grinding through, you know, tough stuff like that. And I'm just thankful for wrestling, man, because it's just fun. I can't wait to wrestle here at PC too. I don't know if they told you. I'm gonna be wrestling here as well.
Okay, yeah, that's great.
So I'm excited to get back on the mat too. You know, here in a few months.
Yeah.
It's gonna be a good opportunity. It's gonna be a fun time.
I don't think people outside of who know wrestling really realize how good South Carolina wrestling and the tradition and the culture is.
Oh, for sure.
I mean,
for sure.
South Carolina wrestling is legit.
It is, man. It is, and we going back to our program in high school, we had a lot of really good coaches. And a lot of them were from, you know, around our state. A few of them wrestled at Clemson back in the day when they had their program.
Right.
And one of our coaches, he was a three-timer from our school. He wrestled at UTC, and he's a National Wrestling Hall of Fame. So, yeah, it's definitely growing in South Carolina too, you know. It's a good atmosphere. The state tournaments are always fun and whatnot. And, yeah, great tradition for sure.
We had Rocky Sin on, you know, before, and I don't know how much you know. I mean, he's gone now, but, you know, he was a big-time wrestler. And so one thing he said stuck out to me is how big for football, you know, you would think, like, you know, body and leverage and that kind of thing, sure. But he was also a lot of about how much of it is – it's a team sport, but it's also you. It's you and another guy out there.
Oh, yeah,
and
for
so
sure.
So how much you learn about, you know, yourself.
Exactly. And that's another part why I was talking about wrestling, why I love it so much, is I can kind of compare when I'm on the line and I'm man up with somebody. It's just me in a wrestling match, you know, because you're wrestling. It's kind of the same idea. You're out there and you got a bunch of people watching just you and one other person go at it. And it teaches you so much about, you know, leverage and whatnot. And it's a mental thing, too. It's just you gotta know before the play, hey, I'm going to beat this guy. Or you got to know before the match, hey, I'm going to beat this guy, you know.
Right.
And, yeah, wrestling and football go hand in hand. And I have so many people ask me, like, hey, which do you like better? I can't pick one, you know.
Yeah.
They're both right here. They've both done so much for me and treated me so well. You know, not just in athletics, but in life. And that's huge.
Well, the cool part is you don't have to. So that's
exactly,
pretty neat. Yeah.
Exactly.
So I was reading, you're a graphic design art guy, is that right?
Yes, I am.
Talk to me about that.
So I mean, from early on, I've always liked to draw. You know, I've always been into stuff like that. Drawing comic book characters and whatnot, and that's always just been cool to me. And then in high school, I got into Photoshop a good bit, so graphic design was just like where I wanted to go to. I knew then, I was just like, I want to make football posters, you know, I want to do stuff like that, even, you know, editing pictures and whatnot. So that was something I discovered in early high school, and I just really stuck with it and wanted to do it. And definitely be something, you know, I want to have a career in one day for sure. My brother, he's a videographer.
Okay.
So, you know, graphic design and videography and stuff like that can go hand in hand. So I'll definitely try to jump on with him eventually, hopefully, if, you know, it works out.
That'd be cool. Yeah. It's the creative fields, you know.
Oh, for sure. For
sure. That's a cool marriage where you got, you know, kind of, I don't want to be reductive here, but, you know, the brawn of wrestling and football, but also, you know, the creative outlet of what you want to do.
Oh, yeah, exactly. And, you know, I play guitar, too, so,
you know,
hopefully one day have a band. I don't know. It would be cool.
Renaissance.
Cool.
You could do your own liner notes and your own
art. Exactly. I'm into a different genre of music than most people talk about, so it's all good, though. You know, I have a buddy. He can shred on guitar, you know, and, you know, we've been talking things over. He's actually about to go in the Marines.
Okay.
So once he's out and I'm out of college, we're going to, hey, man, we're going to get this thing started, you know?
That's what specifically?
Heavy metal.
Oh,
that's,
nice.
That's, you know, I like heavy metal so much because I would listen to it before wrestling or football.
Sure.
And, you know, it gets you ready to go. I'd always tell people it makes me want to rip somebody's head off, you know?
Yeah.
But, I mean, I guess that's the mindset you have to be in when it's you and one other guy going at it.
Right.
But, yeah, that's just a genre I've always liked, you know, especially getting ready for sports. It gets me pretty pumped up.
You're working on the hair there.
Yeah,
metal hair.
I am. It was like 2 weeks ago. I was just like, man, I'm going to do something different, you know. You know, not that you need, you know, hair or tattoos to stand out, but, you know, it's just something I like. Makes you feel fresh. Gives you a fresh mindset on things.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, man.
That sounds pretty good.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
I feel like we haven't really talked about football this football show. But
yeah, of course, no.
We're talking to Gavin James and the Tommy Spangler Coaches Show. We only have a few more minutes, but, you know, this season, it's been such a wild ride, not only with football, but we've talked about, because Coach mentioned, I was like, oh, you know, you get your weekly routine where you play Saturday and you're off Sunday, and he goes, well, we haven't had that because this has been such a weird.
It's been insane.
Yeah, I mean.
It's been insane.
So how is it? That's probably been for you. different, but you know, you're kind of, you don't know anything else from for.
Yeah,
you know,
like I just mean, you don't know any better. It was definitely a little awkward at first. So I was like, because it's not supposed to be like this,
yeah,
you know,
right.
Like we're supposed to be on a grind right now,
yeah.
not you know getting a break, you know, like two weeks in a row or so.
Right.
You know, thanks to the weather and whatnot, but you know, it is what it is, and you just try to work through it. You know, we've had like two or three like. Storm delays, you know, in the middle of games, and that's tough. But you just gotta fix yourself and keep the mindset that hey, we still gotta get out there and we gotta finish this game, you know. But yeah, it'll be different next year, I imagine.
Right.
You know, unless something else crazy like that happens. But it's all good though, you know, just something to learn from, no doubt.
The guys that you're blocking for, you know, John Walker's, all those kind of guys. I mean, what have you learned from them and guys who've been around for a while?
They're really good leaders, you know. They've helped me out a lot and kind of took me under a wing in a way and, you know, just talked to me about things and encouraged me whenever, you know, I'd mess up on a play or whatever. Because, you know, they were already there before me, you know what
right.
I mean? So those guys have been a lot of help to me. So it's, you know, I take care of them, they take care of me, a type deal for sure.
Gavin James, we're out of time. I appreciate you talking to me.
Can I give a shout-out real
sure,
quick?
Sure, yeah.
Shout out to my mom
yeah.
for getting me here, man.
Yeah.
You know, Division I football, couldn't do it without her. I really appreciate that. And, you know, all glory to my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, of course. That's
appreciate
one,
it.
I appreciate it, man.
Gavin,
thank you for having me.
Can't wait to watch you and the Blue Hose this weekend, 6 p.m., Charleston Southern. We will see you next week right here on the Tommy Spangler Coaches Show, sponsored by Founders Federal Credit Union and Selfridge and Lawrence and House of Pizza from Clinton.